In this video, I'm going to be taking you on a trip to Europe with all costs covered. And not only that, you will also be getting a stipend of 1300 euros per month. This is an amazing opportunity that is open to all. There is no age limit. There is no nationality limit. There's also no field restriction. I'm sure at this point you're thinking Nidhi has probably lost her mind, but hey, hello and namaste. This is the Nidhi Nagori channel and this is what we do here. We explore amazing global opportunities which you and I discover together, and we also find ways to remain financially stable through work from home opportunities which are again global in nature. So I like to cover global opportunities because I feel like having a global career in today's day and age is something that most of us want. So if you're looking for a fully funded trip to Europe where you're going to be working and there's also a possibility of future work after that, then this is the right video for you. So first up, let me quickly talk about the background. Now, I'm sure you've noticed it's visually very different from where I typically shoot. That's because I'm in India currently and I'm shooting wherever I can. So I will be traveling across India, visiting a lot of family, seeing a lot of friends, hopefully seeing some of you as well. And while my videos are mostly serious, I also want to keep them light and fun. So I want you to go and take a guess. Where do you think I am currently? Put them down in the comment box with city, maybe with state, whatever you think the best guess is. I've already told you I'm in India and now let's go to Europe together. So this opportunity is called the EU Blue Book Traineeships. These are traineeships which are for a period of 5 months every year and they're held twice in a year. So basically it's 5 months. The first batch happens from March to July and thereafter. So you have about 10 months in a year, but obviously you cannot apply to both cohorts. I mean, you can apply to as many cohorts as you want. There's no limit on applications at all, but you cannot get selected in both the cohorts. Europe has many such opportunities. And as we move ahead on this channel, I will be covering a lot of those for you in detail. So make sure you subscribe. But all of that is going to come later. Right now, let's look at this opportunity in detail. So I've already mentioned when it comes to eligibility criteria, if you go to their page, it clearly states that this traineeship is mostly for European nationals, but there are a number of seats that are also reserved for people who don't come from Europe. So it doesn't matter where you come from. This is a traineeship that's worth applying to. There are multiple openings because you can imagine this is the European Commission traineeship. Just the number of opportunities that are out there, the number of openings that are out there, and the openings are across fields. That's why they don't even specify which field do they need people in, because they literally need people in every field. Also, what I love about this opportunity is that there is no age limit. Typically, when I see opportunities, most of the opportunities that I see, especially when it's for younger people, if it's a traineeship, if it's a fellowship, if it's an internship, it's typically between the age of 18 to 30. Most people like to keep it between an age group. Even if it's not 30, it might be 35. I mean, that applies to even the government opportunities that Government of India is publishing for that matter. But this is a much better opportunity in the sense that it does not matter what your age is. Of course, the more experience you have, the better you'll tend to do. So the more experience you have, the more diversity that you can bring in, the better you'll fare when it comes to applications. And I think it's an amazing way to try and get European experience. Like I said, I'll also talk about how these traineeships can translate into career opportunities, because that's also mentioned on the website and I got all their info from the website itself. So we'll talk about all of that. But I do think that this is an excellent way of getting European experience. Even if you think that I'm not sure, like, do I really want to work? Do I really want to like do a job? If you just want to try something, then I think this is good because you can do this for 5 months. It can be a good way of assessing if this is something like moving abroad is really something that interests you. And then you can take it ahead from there. Now let's come to the application. Just so that you know, there's a whole bunch of documents that you will be expected to submit to put in your application. This includes your passport. It also includes your educational verifications, like all your educational credentials. You should have something related to that. So you should have like a degree, or if you can, get it vetted, get it signed, get it, you know, stamped, all of that. So you have to put in your educational background info. You also have to put in your experience or your workex. Now, in the FAQ section on the website, I did see a question where somebody had asked, you know, what if I cannot get a letter, an experience letter for my work experience? Can that be counted? And they said no. So you really need to only include work experience for which you can go and get a letter signed and stamped by your employer or your past employers. That's very important. I'm sure you're thinking, who's going to tell your current employer? If you can avoid your current experience, if that's the only experience that you have, then put it. And then once maybe you go through pre-selection or once you get selected, maybe that's the time where you can come up with the letter, you know, when you put in your notice. There's also something unique here, which is a language certification. Now, all these European countries, they typically need people to be fluent in at least one of their languages. There's a whole bunch of languages that you can be fluent in. Of course, I find English to be my pick because it's just something that comes naturally to me. Now, I'm sure you're going to be asking me, do we need to write IELTS or TOEFL for this? If you've done your undergrad, postgrad, whatever level of education you have, if you've done that in an institution where the medium of teaching was English, then you don't need anything to prove your language capabilities. All right, what happens if you're not selected? Well, the good thing is it doesn't matter whether you're selected or not. You can keep applying until you hear back from them. So it depends on how persistent you want to be. What happens if you do get selected? So they're pretty good in the sense that they only select the number of trainees. The number of trainees is always equal to the number of positions that they have available. Once you go through a pre-selection, they'll send you all the options, like all the positions that are available. And you are advised to, you know, mark or check off as many as you can. It doesn't have to be just one field or one role. Any role that interests you or any profile that interests you, you're just expected to check off, and then they'll do the final match and assign you the role that you'll finally go into. I think I kind of like this approach as well because it really gives you the flexibility to pick not one but multiple options for yourself. So there's a lot of introspection, according to me, that you have to go through, and then you know at the end that you will end up getting something that you like. I'm sure you're wondering what happens after the 5 months, right? Because we spoke about how this traineeship is only 5 months. So what happens after that? So once you complete your traineeship, further career opportunities are present and they're mentioned on a completely separate website. It's linked on the current website, so it's on the FAQ section itself. It's the EPSO website. Now let's talk about what possible locations you can be located in. So most of the EU roles are located in Brussels in Belgium, but you could also be in Luxembourg, Grange, and a few other European cities. More likely than not, most roles are in Brussels, so you can expect yourself to be in Belgium eating some amazing Belgian waffles. Once you start your role, you will be eligible for 1300 euros per month as stipend. Your visa and insurance costs will all be covered. The only cost that will not be covered is the accommodation. They will help you find the accommodation, but they will not cover the cost. They have given a range though. They say that you're going to end up paying anywhere between 350 to 550 euros per month, which I think is pretty fair given that you'll be earning 1300 euros per month, ending up spending 350 euros to 550 euros for getting this amazing experience. I don't think it's a big deal at all. I'm sure you're already wondering, we've done all this discussion, but where is the website? How do I go and apply? So you can see the link on the screen right now. I will try to leave the link in the description box, but it won't be a direct link because I tend to get some strikes sometime. I've had, you know, websites and companies reach out to me and ask me to take it down. So I don't want to go through that. So I will leave either the info in the description box or in the pinned comment or on screen. Either ways, you'll definitely find it in this video somewhere. On that note, this amazing video has come to an end. I hope you like this video and I hope you will apply for this opportunity. Let me know what you think about it. Let me know in the comments if you do end up going and applying, and obviously if you have any other questions about it. I promise to see you in the next video. Until then, please make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon, and let me know in the comments if you have any other requests or ideas or thoughts about what kind of videos you want to see here. You take care and see you in the next video. Namaste.